Hello and welcome to odds on Europa League. We are gonna give you some tips for the best 10 games we have in this first match day. We have Dani Fisichella with us, and of course we want to know your opinion. Let me know all your tips and predictions in the comment section, and of course support us by clicking on the like button, subscribing to our channel and clicking on the bell to get notifications. And now let's go on with the show. First match day of the Europa League. We have so many games, but we picked only the best 10, Dani. And there are always many surprises in this group stage of the Europa League. How are you?
Oh, very well. Ciao, Edo. But it's the old name, but it's almost a new competition because there are less teams, because obviously UEFA has created a new cup competition on a Thursday. So obviously it's much more competitive. If you look at the groups, they're all evenly balanced and there are a lot of big games already in this match day one.
There might be some tricky ones. And as I said, let's start with Bayer Leverkusen, Ferencbaros. Leverkusen, they are six in the Bundesliga. They haven't started bad at all, even if they lost at the weekend against Borussia Dortmund, but they are scoring a lot, Dani. And they were a bit disappointed last season where they were out against Young Boys. I think we all expected Leverkusen to arrive further in this competition. Whereas Ferencbaros, they were out also against Young Boys in the preview of the Champions League. That's why they are in this Europa League. Probably we should expect goals here.
Yes, they should expect goals because Leverkusen are the second best attack in Bundesliga. They've scored 12. They scored 3 at the weekend, but they lost against Borussia Dortmund. And, you know, they got a lot of talents up front. They got Schick, already scoring 3 consecutive Bundesliga games. Florian Wirtz is, again, in good form. And, you know, new faces as well. Adili Kusumu, that he plays at the back, 23 million from Bruges. So it is a team full of talent that obviously is going to target another top 4 finish in Bundesliga. They have conceded 4 at the weekend, but you know, back up until then they were also the second best defense in Bundesliga, if only after 4 games. And they play a Ferencváros team at home who won the last 2 games in a row in Hungary. It is a team that started their campaign very, very early. The first game was on the 6th of July, the first qualifying rounds of the Champions League. And I remember against Young Boys, especially in the first leg that they played in Switzerland, they had load of chances. They lost 3-2, but they could have scored a couple more. Also because, you know, neither Young Boys or Ferencváros are great defensively. I think they are certainly a threat, no matter whether they play at home or away. It's a team that last year did the Champions League, finished bottom of the group, but, you know, they are building up experience. Both to score, I like that one, 2.30.
Yep, good odds for both teams to score. Then let's go to Croatia, Dinamo Zagreb, West Ham. This is a tricky trip for a Premier League team, that last season they were great and also they started good this season in England, 8 points despite the last 2 consecutive draws. After 5 seasons away, West Ham is back to Europe, Dani, and Maximir is never an easy stadium. Tottenham, the rivals of West Ham, no, because they were knocked out of the Europa League last season. And also we were a bit surprised with Dinamo Zagreb. We analyzed them where they played against Sheriff Tiraspol because we expected them to be in the Champions League group stages, but they lost against the Moldavian team. That's why they are here topping their group and in good form. So difficult for West Ham.
Dinamo Zagreb are trying to get their season back on track. They had a slow start in the Croatian League and I think they were kind of sure to be in the Champions League group stages. See how they react from the big disappointments of losing in Tiraspol and drawing 0-0 at home against them in a must-win game. So in the end, it's Europa League for them. And yes, we remember the great game they played last year against Tottenham at the Maximir, but they cannot just rest on their laurels. I mean, the legacy of that game has long gone. So for Orisic and company, they need to step up again, because this is a tough game against West Ham. Okay, they are back in Europe in the last 4 years. They come from an extraordinary campaign, 2020-2021, built around defensive solidity. Not just the defense, but the midfield, very hard working, you know, the arrival of Suchek 2 years ago, we mentioned it, and also paired with other very important players that I think has given a lot of strength and depth to West Ham. They will play with Mikel Antonio, because he's been sent off in the game against Southampton. He's a top goal scorer, and curiously, in the Premier League, David Moyes has deployed the same formation for the last 4 games. So now they will obviously make some changes, also because they got Man United at the weekend. Let's see how the changes that Moyes brings in, I could expect 7 or 8 at least, perform. This is a chance for Vlasic, the new signing, Yarmolenko, who does it with Ukraine, not quite with West Ham, Zuma, Kral, Lanzini. So obviously there is personnel there. Let's see how they perform, because, you know, for the first time they will start from the first minute. They need to be better in the final third than they were at Southampton. But for this one, I don't think Dinamo Zagreb are going to lose at home. I'm going to be cautious. Asian handicap 0. 240. So if Dinamo Zagreb wins, you win the stake. If they do not lose, well, basically, if they draw, you don't lose your stake.
Dinamo Zagreb, Asian handicap 0 here. Then Galatasaray, Lazio. I pretty much like the odds for Lazio. 2.10, in my opinion, one of the favorites to arrive very far away in this Europa League, because I kind of like this season Lazio, even if they had they suffered the first defeat of the season this weekend against Milan, with this new project created by Sarri, Dani, and Galatasaray. They were playing actually the preview of the Champions League, but they were completely thrashed by PSV. Therefore, they had to play a couple of previous rounds in this Europa League. Probably they have the name, but not the players anymore.
This is a tie that reminds you of Champions League in the mid-90s, when, you know, when the Alisamien was a very, 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 very tough place to go. We'll find out on Tuesday whether it's still the same. With Lazio, obviously managed by Sarri, who won this competition in 2018 with Chelsea. And, you know, at the weekend, disappointing Lazio. They suffered a lot against Milan, lost 2-0. Milan pressed them really, really high. They didn't let them play. Lazio were bad both defensively, and when they had to build the play, they couldn't use the entire width of the pitch, always into narrow spaces. Milan robbed possession quite a lot. Well, once Sarri said that it takes almost 3 years for his teams to assimilate his ideas. We are only 3 games into the season, so we can't expect too much, but they need a reaction. Probably this team under Simone Inzaghi wasn't used to press so much. They were more of a counter-attacking team. We know Sarri, it's a different mentality, of course. That is going to make a lot of changes. I'm expecting a start for the Kosovarian Muriki up front. Remember, they signed him for almost 20 millions last year. He hasn't quite delivered, but yes, we're gonna see a lot of changes as well. And last year, you know, the subs of Lazio weren't quite up to the task. That's why also Lazio crashed out of the Europa League really early. We'll see. Let's see how the team has been strengthened. For Galatasaray, yes, I mean, the past glories, but this is the past. They only won one of the last 30 European games, excluding the qualifiers. No wins in 13. Actually, they lost 9. And this season, they were heavily defeated by PSV. They always conceded so far in the qualifying rounds of the Champions League and the Europa League. They got experience. They got experience in Muslera, who, by the way, used to play for Lazio, Van Aanholt, Ryan Babel, a young Dervisoglu up front, who used to play for Brentford. You know, the environment could be the key. Let's see how it goes. I think Galatasaray to score first could be a good odd. 240.
Oh, you think that there might... a surprise at the Alizamigen, and these two teams, Galatasaray and Lazio, are in Group E, together with Lokomotiv Moscow and Marseille. So Marseille and Lazio, they are favorites to go through. Also because Marseille, they started the season pretty well in France. They are third, even with one game in hand. Sampaoli is building a very interesting team, very offensive one, with good players like Cecik Under, for instance, or Dimitri Payet. Lokomotiv third in Russia. Dani, Marseille favorites here.
They are favorites because despite Lokomotiv being unbeaten in the Russian league, I think they are maybe a bit untested in European football at this level. I think this could be tough for them. Last year they finished third in the Russian league. They really never quite challenged for the title, and they have, I think, they got good players. I mean, Fyodor Smolov, we saw him playing for Russia more and more. I think now he's gonna start more games under the new manager Karpin. Miranchuk, one of the two brothers, obviously the one that did a move to Atalanta. They are quite skillful, quick. They could trouble Marseille if they play, of course, because let's not forget this is a competition where often there are many changes. The bad news for Lokomotiv is they only kept one clean sheet in 9 games so far, but they always score. Just then in one occasion they didn't score. Marseille, they look to start, they are absorbing Sampaoli's vision. Well, I don't know how many years it takes Sampaoli to mold the team. Sarri said 3 years, I don't know, maybe Sampaoli will be less, 3 months, but they start to absorb it. They start looking like a Sampaoli team also, because he's been there since February, let's face it. So he had a season and half a season already to adjust, playing his trademark 3-4-2-1 that we saw with Chile, we saw with Argentina, with mixed results. But, you know, they brought some interesting players, of course, Under, Guendouzi, Lirola used to play for Fiorentina, and then Gerson from Flamengo. High price tag for this experienced midfielder, experience in Italy, and obviously in Brazil, so he could be really the person who can make them tick in the middle of the field. So they have spent quite a lot in the summer, and they expect a good season, and they were very good at the weekend as well. I saw them against Monaco, 2 goals from Dieng, quick, explosive, 2 goals in his first start. So you can tell Sampaoli does not lack courage when he makes the selections. I can see goals because, you know, a Sampaoli team is always going to go for it. Over 2.5 goals, very good odds, 1.94.
Then let's go to Sevilla. Actually, Sampaoli lived there for a while and we can see his footprint in Sevilla. But now we are talking about Betis facing Celtic. Also Celtic, one of these teams, clubs that the old glories passed. Actually, they lost recently the Old Firm. Last season they were unable to win the Scottish League. They were kicked out very early also in the previews of the Champions League. And Betis, Dani, is a difficult team to predict always. They got the first victory in La Liga yesterday on Monday against Granada, but they are not playing great. It's very difficult to read this Pellegrini's team.
And also, I noticed that Betis played yesterday, finished to play almost at midnight in Spain. Celtic played on Saturday, so they almost have 2 days and a half rest more than Betis. Not really fair, is it? I don't think La Liga give a hand to Betis, who, as you mentioned, yes, Pellegrini's team, not a great start of the season, definitely an experienced side, but they finished last year very strongly with 11 games unbeaten, including draws with Atletico Madrid and Real Madrid, which allowed them then to qualify in sixth place for the Europa League. Interesting, last year they scored 50, they conceded 50, so quite balanced. That means often they win 1-0, you know, the games, they're not a lot of goals in those games, but they were one of the worst defense in the top half of the table. So it is something that Pellegrini needs to look at. They replaced Emerson Royal with Bellerin. See how the complexion changes, but pretty much is the same team of last year, still with the great Joaquim pulling the strings in midfielder. Celtic, I think they have a problem with scoring goals this season. They are a team in transformation, especially now that the Japanese Furuhashi is out with an injury. Injury has been great at the beginning of the season. It solved a lot of problems with them, especially in the game against AZ Alkmaar in the first, in the last qualifying rounds for the Europa League. At the weekend, they were stubborn against Ross County. They had to try to finally find the breakdown against a team that defended pretty much all the game. Postecoglou, the Australian manager, by the way, he's the first Australian to manage in the Europa League ever. So he's building the team, he's reconstructing the team, he's trying to instill a different mentality, he's building the play from the back, more of a passing game, try not to rush, be more composed on the ball. It takes time, I think, for them to be competitive and competitive with Rangers this year, considering also, the outgoings in the market. They also lost Hudson Edouard in the end. So it's a transition season for them, but I think for them the target could be Europe or do a good campaign in Europe. And as I said, they are slightly more rested. They arrive in Spain with, a fresher mind, I will say. I like the double chance, X2, so either a draw or a win for Celtic, 2.28.
Surprise here, Joaquin, by the way, he was complaining because he's not playing enough, in his opinion, in this start of the season, but he's quite experience, let's say. Then Monaco, Sturmgrad, very, very bad start of the season for Monaco, for Kovac. They were out of the Champions League preview, even if they were this close to qualify against Shakhtar Donetsk. In the weekend, they lost, as we mentioned before, against Marseille. And Sturmgrad, they are second in the Austrian Bundesliga after, of course, Salzburg. It's been a while, actually, without seeing Sturmgrad in a European competition in the group stages. Dani, so favorite Monaco at one point, they need to react, they need a good result.
I think Monaco supporters need to look at the positive in this very difficult moment. They are creating chances, they are dominating games, they are just not scoring enough, or they are not creating quality chances. They create half chances, but I think all the propositions are there. I mean, this is a team that last year for a bit fought for the title, or thought they could fight for the title in France. So the talent is not lost. They have been maybe a little bit unlucky in some games. For example, the return game against Shakhtar in the UEFA Champions League knockout, they should have gone through. They were so unlucky. They dominated the game, even I will say both games. So the quality is obviously there. And there are some individual performances as well, even in the defeat against Marseille, Tchouameni, Kai Enrique, Fofana. The problem is that, Folland and his partner El Nassiri in up front, they're not scoring. And this is quite unusual. Bit of a question mark whether Golovin will play. He picked up an injury a few days ago, so it could be interesting to see if actually Kovacs risked him, because they need a win, and they can get a win against Sturmgrad, because Sturmgrad is an inexperienced team. This is the first time they reached the group stage in the last 10 years. Back then they lost 5 out of 6 games, so they really haven't got the European pedigree. They are 7 points behind Salzburg in the Austrian League, who won them all. They finished third last year, and also in the Austrian League they haven't scored even that many, just over 50. So I don't think they can pose a great threat to Monaco. Again, look at the lineups, because there could be changes. Look if Golovin is playing, but assuming he is, I think Monaco is going to capitalize on the chances they will create. So Asian handicap -1.5, 2.30. So to win your stake, Monaco needs to win by 2 goals margin.
I remember Sturmgrad playing the Champions League in the Arnold Schwarzenegger.
We do. We do.
Yeah, Real Madrid traveling to Austria, to Graz, to play that game. Then we were talking about Monaco, that they haven't started well the season. What to say about Eintracht Frankfurt? Now they face Fenerbahce. They only have, the German team, only have 3 points in this start of the Bundesliga, no victories. We were always commenting with Radek Vegas that they lost Andres Silva and a lot of quality. And Glasner, the new coach, is not working yet. And they face a Fenerbahce team. They are third in the Turkish league. And they have some big names. Dani, they have Mesut Özil or yep. Luis Gustavo, for instance.
This could be finally balanced, I think, because Eintracht is not in a great form, as you mentioned, whereas Fenerbahce are stronger at home in Europe rather than away. So let's start with Eintracht. Three consecutive draws. They could not beat Stuttgart the weekend. Stuttgart with 10 men, and in the end they equalize in the very last minute. So there is also a bit of a confidence issue. How do they replace the many goals scored by Adrian Silva? There have been a lot of changes this summer, a lot of loans, players coming and going. Probably in the end, even Filip Kostic wanted to leave, really wanted to go somewhere else, but Lazio couldn't manage to sign him. There was a little bit of mistakes with the negotiations, so, you know, in the end he ended up in chaos, but he was an unhappy player at the end. Fenerbahce are doing well in the league, just one goal conceded in four games. They only won one of the, but you know, when you look at the, I got some stats, when you look at the away games in the Europa League, they only won only two of the last 15 Europa League games, excluding the qualifiers. So they don't travel very well. And, you know, as, probably they'll have more chances when they play at home. For this one, Eintracht Frankfurt to win the first half, 2.25. I mean, based especially on the form from last year, I would say.
For sure, there will be many Turkish supporters in the for a stadium, as we all know. Then the best game of this match day, for sure. Actually, these teams were very close to qualify for the Champions League last season. Leicester City, Napoli, very tough one to call. They both should arrive far in this competition. Leicester, Danny, lost 0-1 in the weekend against Man City. Also, they have one thing in common. I think that the last season both played in the Europa League, and they were a bit disappointed because Leicester lost against Slavia Prague, whereas Napoli, they lost against Granada. We both expected, I guess, to arrive way farther away. But for this game, Napoli arrived a bit better, of course, because they beat Juventus, although you are not convinced yet about this Napoli. They are still building up a new team, of course.
I think with Spalletti, yes, they are building up a new team, new confidence. The big job for Spalletti this season is to make the players believe that they are as good as anybody else in the Italian league. So avoid lapses of concentration, mood swings that sometimes let them lose points or games in a stupid way. And we saw against Juventus, they didn't start the game really well because they conceded a very stupid goal with a mistake from Manolas. They were under the cosh for 10-15 minutes. Then they had better rhythm. They were quicker on the ball. So in the end, they ended up suffocating Juventus. But I think they suffer too much from the game. In reality, they should have controlled it also because Juventus had a lot of absentees. They played a high tempo in the end, made the most of Juventus' mistakes. So they are top of the league in Italy with 9 points, but I think they have been a touch lucky. Also, the previous game against Genoa, I think they got 3 points. They deserve just one. The problem with Napoli is that they really didn't strengthen the squad this summer because they should have brought a new left back, and they're still stuck with Mario Rui. They should have brought perhaps another creative midfielder. Instead, they brought a defensive midfielder, which is very good, like Zambo Anguissa. And then, you know, there is always the question whether how many games Mertens is going to start. They got Petagna up front. Do they trust him enough to make him start this sort of game? So, you know, there are quite of selection issues there. They're still dealing with a couple of small injuries to players. I know that they brought back Unas, for example, from the loan at Crotone again, but he has to step up with other players. So this could be a really tough trip for Napoli, because last year Leicester, yes, they lost against Slavia Praga, but let's not forget they won the FA Cup. So they are very good in cup competitions, especially in knockout. And, you know, okay, they lost against Slavia Praga, but they were negotiating with the fourth place in the Premier League, which they missed for the second season in a row. And it's difficult to play three competitions for a team like Leicester. However, last year, Rodgers' teams won all the group stages games at home. So they have to be favorite for this one. He will make changes as he did last year. Let's see, probably a start for Pat Sondaka from Salzburg. We haven't seen much of him, and he could be, you know, someone who can really be eager to leave a mark. I'm gonna go for a Leicester win on this one, 2.35.
Leicester win, and as I said, this is a very good game. Also, the following one, PSV, Real Sociedad, PSV leaders in the Dutch Eredivisie. They also won the Dutch Super Cup, and they are scoring a lot of goals. They were also this close to qualify for the group stages of the Champions League, but they lost against Benfica, whereas Real Sociedad also good start for them in La Liga. They are fourth right now. They won at the weekend. Also, last season, Danny, they were quite competitive in Europe. They only lost against Man United. PSV favorites, but I even like the odds for the Dutch team.
For me, this is the best game. This is the game to watch, because I believe this could be the year of PSG, both domestically, also in Europe. I'm not going to say they're going to win the Europa League, but, you know, they got a lot of talents, especially young talents. Madueke, the Englishman, Gakpo, he already plays for the Dutch national team, combined with experienced player Zahawi from Israel, he's scoring domestically and with his national team. Götze can still do it, you know, he showed us. And, you know, he's a very good team, and they deserve much more against Benfica as well in the Champions League knockout. So I think, again, they should be strong favorites for to win this group, and they score a lot, score 17 goals in the last six games. Ajax are gonna find a tougher opponent in the Eredivisie this year. Real Sociedad, three clean sheets after the initial defeat to Barcelona, so a decent start of the season as well. Last year they had a good defense, so that poor defensive display against Manchester United in the Europa League was strange, but in La Liga they conceded 38 goals, which, you know, is a decent tally, same as Barcelona. You know, they didn't concede many, and they haven't changed much really in the summer. It's pretty much the same team, but they got much more European experience. Oyarzabal, you know, played at the Euros, played at the Olympics. Well, if he's not knackered, hopefully he will play against PSV Eindhoven. And then Isak, very good European experience, was very good, probably one of the young player of the tournament at the Euros. Again, very good with Sweden in the qualifiers, score against Spain. So there could be goals in it, but I see the home side slightly favorite. I want to be cautious. So PSV Asian handicap 0, 1.82. Okay, the odds are not massive, but think about it. You know, you just try to preserve your stake. If PSV wins, you win 1.82. If they do not lose, you get your money.
Oyarzabal, he scored both goals actually in the weekend against Cádiz for Real Sociedad. And our last game, let's go to Scotland, Rangers Lyon. We check the odds here, it's very, very balanced, pretty much the same for both sides. Rangers, Scottish champions, they failed to qualify to the Champions League. Huge disappointment, in my opinion. They lost to Malmo, whereas Lyon, Danny, after a slow start of the season for Boss, they were able to win the last two games in the league, and they have a lot of talent, even if they lost Memphis the night.
Rangers, again, is like Dinamo Zagreb. I bet they didn't think they were going to be here in September. They thought they're going to be in the Champions League, because the draw seemed favorable against Malmo. They were outpaced by Malmo. Malmo had better condition back in mid of August. Rangers couldn't cope with the physicality. However, you know, now Rangers are start producing what they did last year. You know, they start getting back on track. The thing with last year Rangers, they had an amazing home record in Scotland. They were unbeaten. And, you know, they found a way to win tough matches even when they were not playing very well. Now what happened to Rangers is that they need to start producing 90 minutes performances. They need to dominate games more. So far, they played well back here and then. But, you know, I think you know, there's still a bit of work in progress. So this could be a very important game in the development of the season. But they play a tough opposition. Lyon are a bit strange so far, you know, strange results. For example, 3-3 a couple of weeks ago against Clermont Foot, the newly promoted. They had the game basically won, they threw it away. Then at the weekend, 3-1, much more convincing against Strasbourg, which is, you know, more accomplished team than Clermont Foot. The new manager, Peter Bosch, is doing really well. Did really well against Leverkusen. So give him a little bit of time, considering also that in the summer there's been a little bit of a revolution. Depay going out, but they brought in many players, most of them in the very last minute of the transfer market. Players like Emerson Palmieri, Shaqiri, Boateng, Dembélé got him a bit earlier. So they need to assemble the team, which still has got quite a lot of talent in there. You know, there's Paquetá, for example, who's doing well, has been doing well for last year and a half. This could be maybe tough to call in the outright market, but I think Lyon are going to start strongly. So Lyon to score first, 2-5.
Yep, Paquetá scoring many goals also in Copa America. Danny, we have the best team game. We have big names of European football in this Europa League. Let's see what we can do also with our ACCA, because there are so many games that we can put them together and try to make even more money.
I chose five games for you. Bayer Leverkusen to win, Marseille to win, Betis and Celtic both to score, Leicester and Napoli over 2.5 goals, and Rangers and Lyon both to score. The total odds for this ACCA is 15.08.
Perfect, Danny. Thank you very much, as always. Let's try to make some money and see you very soon.
See you soon. Enjoy. Bye-bye.
Brilliant! We have now our ACCA for Thursday's games. We also have every single tip that Danny gave us. You can see them all right now on the screen. But of course, apart from Danny's predictions, I want to know yours. Let me know what you think in the comment section as always. And if you enjoy our videos, don't forget and click on the like, subscribe and click on the bell to get notifications. Or if you prefer, also, we have a podcast for you. See you very soon and enjoy the Europa League.